Hi, I'm Dr. Seema Yasmin. I'm a medical doctor and journalist at the Stanford Center for Health Education, and welcome to Viral Facts with Digital Medic. Today, I'm discussing some background about COVID crises around the world and answering questions about what to do if you or someone you know has COVID-19 and you don't have immediate access to a clinic or hospital. So let's start with this. What's happening in India? India is currently in the middle of a COVID-19 crisis, with over 24.3 million cases reported and over 266,000 deaths. The crisis has left India with a shortage in hospital beds, oxygen, medications, and protective equipment. And many have not been able to access medical care, so it's become especially important for people to monitor their health from home as much as possible. Other countries such as Thailand, Pakistan, Turkey, Brazil, Uruguay, and Paraguay are also seeing a dramatic rise in case numbers. In general, if you're limited in resources with minimal access to healthcare, take note of these recommendations. First, what medicines should you be taking? We have heard reports of people spending a fortune to purchase hydroxychloroquine and other experimental drugs. Experimental drugs are, well, just that, they're experimental, and you should not waste your money on these drugs as there's no guarantee that they will help you or your loved ones, and in fact, they could cause harm. Also, antibiotics are usually not the solution because COVID-19 is a viral infection, not a bacterial one. Instead, focus on staying hydrated, treating your fever or pain with anti-inflammatories, such as acetaminophen, and continuing to take your inhaler if you have asthma. And keep monitoring your symptoms for development of shortness of breath. That's really important. This brings me to my next point. Really, how do you monitor your health at home? Monitoring clinical signs and symptoms carefully is important. If you have a fever of over 38 degrees Celsius, that's 100.3 degrees Fahrenheit, use a cold washcloth and acetaminophen as needed. Avoid taking more than 4 grams of acetaminophen in 24 hours. It's really important to ensure adequate hydration and to get plenty of fluids. Warm saline gargles and cough drops or lozenges can also help with a sore throat. Be on the lookout for signs of worsening disease, such as difficulty breathing. And if you can, use a pulse oximeter to check oxygen levels every 6 hours. Oxygen levels over 90% are sufficient for most people. And if oxygen is not available, lay on your stomach with one pillow beneath the neck, 1 to 2 pillows below the chest through the upper thighs, and 2 pillows below the shins. With the increase of infections in some parts of the world, it's really important to have a plan for where you could seek medical care if an emergency happens. Just keep in mind, if your oxygen levels are okay, you could be turned away. So don't panic while hospitals prioritize the most sick people. Continue to hydrate and take care of yourself. Next, what should you do if a family member is sick? In general, to protect yourself from COVID-19 at home and outside, continue to remain at least 6 feet apart, if possible, and remember to wash your hands and wear a mask. Avoid crowded communal areas and try to have one person, maybe a vaccinated person or someone who's low risk, do the shopping for the family. If a family member is sick, it's important to keep your distance from them, continue wearing masks. Don't eat meals or have social gatherings with your ill family member. If there are multiple people in your household that have COVID-19, take turns getting rest and taking care of one another. Make sure the patient has adequate hydration, such as water, juices, milk, soups, Gatorade, or oral rehydration solutions, and keep the windows in the house open for ventilation if you can. When available, you should be sure to get your COVID vaccine, which will protect you from severe disease and death. That's it for today. Please take a look at the other videos in our Viral Facts playlist for more answers to your COVID-19 questions.